Hey guys, welcome to this video. Not a let's play or a let's try, but a look at a few tactical turn-based games that I'm personally looking forward to and that will be released soonish. So, a little bit relative in some cases. First up, Panzer Corps 2. I think it was originally planned to be released this year, and that is not going to happen as far as I can see. The latest developer diary is from October 22nd, and still polishing and balancing is needed apparently. I read somewhere that they are planning to remove the turn limit in the battles. Not sure why that is. Do they want to make the game more, even more accessible? It's a mystery. I think the turn limit is an integral part of these games. You should just keep it. Screenshots look pretty good, I think, for the alpha version. And this right now doesn't have a real release date other than somewhere in 2019. It's definitely something I look forward to, but need to wait on for quite a while yet. Next up, I think this is a less known game. Klotzen Panzer Battles, made by a small studio. Maxim Games, I think they are called, yes. These guys try to make the next Panzer General. Basically taking the good things from that game and improving upon them, making the game a little bit more realistic with more intricate supply rules. I think they have air interdiction planned. It will be a massive campaign with over 60 scenarios. And this game was also planned to be released this year in the summer. Now obviously that didn't happen. And I guess if you are a small studio, it can be very difficult to get balance right. Get all the mechanics right. And as I said, 60 scenarios, that's a huge number. Integrating that into a meaningful campaign will also be difficult. This is an interview with the creator on wargamer.com for your latest news on your favorite genre. And the air combat system indeed is totally revamped. Very nice. If you take a look at a few screenshots, I think they look amazing. Reminds me a lot of Panzer General. Very nice graphics. And hopefully the AI is as good as they promise. I think they actually mentioned that. An aggressive AI that responds to the changing battlefield and launches counterattacks where it hurts the most. And the supply system revamped. Indeed an air interdiction system. Veteran units, generals with unique personalities. 600 historical unit types and 60 historical and also what-if scenarios. Definitely look forward to this. Release dates unknown. Probably not this year. So somewhere in 2019. What will be released this year is the next expansion of Order of Battle, Endseek, and this will give you an opportunity to play an entire campaign as the Germans, starting with the Blitzkrieg campaign, then importing your core forces in Panzerkrieg or Sandstorm, and after that you can import your forces in Order of Battle and Sieg. This will be released this month. Exact date is unknown. Definitely will do a let's try of this expansion. Now remember, Order of Battle is free to play, but if you want to actually play the game, you need to buy the campaigns. And if you want to buy all the campaigns, it can be pretty costly. Also, you need to remember that Order of Battle, the actual battles are kind of scripted, and if you don't like that, then this is not the game for you. Still, this month, so definitely we'll do a let's try of that and maybe even start a campaign from scratch, so starting in Blitzkrieg. The final game I want to mention, well, here is first a screenshot of Order of Battle and Sieg, Novgorod in 1944. You get to play with the real heavy armor, Tiger II tanks, Jagdpanzer, and also the jet fighters. Very promising. And finally, Unity of Command 2. Now, this has been in development for a long time. Right here you can see an interview with the creators of 2016. Also a small studio. These guys were actually very surprised that the first incarnation of the game did so well. It sold over 100,000 units. It came as a complete shock, apparently. Now, gamers wanted to have the gaming systems applied to other theaters. The first incarnation was specifically focused on the Eastern Front, the Stalingrad battles. But apparently the mechanics weren't really suited for other theaters, so they decided to make version 2. And they're still working on it. The latest development diary is from, what is it? Let me try to find it. I think it was October 31st. No real release date known yet. It does look amazing though. Really looking forward to this. And I may actually do a Unity of Command let's try next. At least do the first mission of the campaign. Not really sure yet, but alright, that's something for the next time. Right now, I want to thank you for watching and see you in the next one.